What wrinkles?
What wrinkles?
Oh my god, I love you. Okay.
Looks okay. You guys ready? So, the first 5 years of our marriage were amazing. It was incredible. You know, pure marital bliss. We had it all. The white picket fence, the dog, the cat, the velvet handcuffs. And to be clear, it was not a literal white picket fence. We mostly just had a lot of disposable forks around because we were so excited about the sex that we forgot to buy cutlery.
For 5 years.
We read tarot cards. We bought matching Doc Martens. That was super fun. And then we donated those Doc Martens to an ex-friend who did installation art. We ate edamame straight out of the bag. Savages. The next 4 years of our marriage were hard. We're hard. I wanted to kill myself. I lost my job at the microchip farm. And, you know, every day I had to look in the mirror and the person that I saw there had an advanced and severe case of nostalgia. I actually broke this arm trying to pick up skateboarding at the age of 33. And then I re-broke this arm when I jumped out of our ground floor window trying to play parkour.
But the next 5 years of our marriage were amazing. I mean, we traveled the world together, we read magazines, we did drugs, we stayed out late. We had it all. We also had two children. We planted seeds, literally, figuratively, and spiritually.
Tell them more about the kids.
Oh yeah, we had two kids. And by had two kids, what I mean is we adopted two kids. And by adopted two kids, what I mean is we e-adopted two kids, which means that we paid for some kids' college sweatshirts over in the Orient. The only person I saw was her. And that other woman that I did start seeing sometimes. I often started seeing my wife with another woman, which then led to the next 3 years of our marriage, which were terrible. I mean, I was sure that the flower of love betwixt us had crumbled and died. I mean, they were together all the time. Naked, in the dark, outside, inside, upstairs, on the ottoman. I mean, I could smell this woman's schmitz on my own wife. Not great for me. Not great. The only thing worse than smelling another woman's schmitz on your wife is nothing. That is the worst thing. I did start using schmitz, though. It is all natural and organic, and I haven't stopped. I mean, I've tried all of the natural deodorants, and that is really the only one that is effective.
Yeah, but, you know, anyway, the next 3 years of our marriage, we were so happy. It was like we were untouchable. Nobody touched us. I stopped seeing that woman. We quit our jobs, and, you know, we sailed east. We sailed north. We bought new iPhones. We traded our sweaters for hoodies and just really let the world take us by the bones, you know? We stopped using gendered pronouns for a while and, you know, that was fun. That was fun. And then we started again and that was fun. I just, you know, we took our hands and just kind of like rested them on each other's faces.
But the next 2 years of our marriage were terrible. I mean, I wanted to kill myself. But you know what? I can't even get into it right now. The important thing is here, I wouldn't have traded this for anything. The ups and the downs, they brought us closer to God. Sometimes literally.
Once or twice.
But, you know, if you spend enough time with anyone, it's going to get rocky. And if your heart says to stay, then you should stick it out. See where love grows you.
I love you.
I love you too.